Hello Internet, I'm Mihai. Today I will show you how to use many SSH keys for the same Git repository. These days, Git repository services allow you to authenticate in two ways, using HTTPS protocol or SSH protocol. I will not show you how they work behind. For this tutorial, it is enough to know that HTTPS will ask you for username, password, or a token instead of password. I'm going to draw a diagram to show how HTTPS connections look like. I will draw a local machine. I will put here the GitHub repository, and the HTTPS connection will need the following parameters. I will draw them. It is the username, it is the password or token. So every time when you want to connect to GitHub or other repository using HTTPS, you will have to provide one of these values. On the other hand, we have SSH. I will move page down, create another local machine. Let's move it down. SSH will ask you for a private key, which must be on the local machine, and the public key must be stored on the Git repository. I will draw a diagram to show you how it works. Here is the GitHub. We need to connect our local machine and GitHub. And we will use SSH connection. SSH, which requires private key. Let's zoom. And the public key. Private key should be on the local machine and should never leave it. And the public key should be on the GitHub repository. And once you have this pair, the private key and public key, you can connect to GitHub, clone, push, patch, do anything you want. In this tutorial, I will show you how to use many private keys to connect to many remote repositories, even if they are under the same domain. I will add two Bitbucket repositories. First repository will be the account Anna, and the second Bitbucket repository will be under the account Yuri. Move a little bit up. Both repositories will have public keys. And of course, on your local machine, you will store private keys. Private key for GitHub. I will move the arrow. Increase the font. Private key for Anna. And private key for Yuri. Let's connect them. So, this is the architecture we will create in this tutorial to use many private keys on the same machine to connect to different remote repositories, even if they are under the same domain. Please remember, if the private key or the public key or the buff keys are wrong, the connection will not be established and you will not be able to clone, fetch, pull, push, and so on. If the keys are correct, Git will manage to connect to remote repositories. Let's create a GitHub repository. I open my GitHub account and I will create a private repository. So, new, repository name gRepo1, no description, private, add readme, no git ignore, no license, create repository. Congratulations, we created a repository. Let's create the first Bitbucket repository. I go to the Bitbucket repository, it is Anazolf account, and I create a repository. Project. I'm titled repository name bRepo1. It's a private repository. Yes, we generate a README. No default branch. No git ignore. No description. And everything else leaves as default. Create repository. Congratulations, we created a Bitbucket repository. Let's create the second Bitbucket repository. I go to the another browser. It is another Bitbucket account, YuriFio. And I create a repository. Project untitled, repository name bRepo2, private repository, generate a README, dot generate git ignore, no description, and everything else leaves as default. Create repository. The repository is created, congratulations. Now it is time to create the SSH keys. I will need a file explorer tool and a terminal. I am on Linux, so I use terminal and Dolphin file explorer, but on Windows I suggest using git bash. I open Dolphin File Explorer, here it is, and I create a working directory. Folder keys. and I open the terminal inside that directory. Now I can create the first pair of keys. I will create the bRepo1 key, SSH key again, type ECDSA, number of bits 552, and the comment bitbucket repo1. I made a mistake, let's correct it. ECDSA, everything is alright, enter. I will put the file name bRepo1, enter. No passphrase, just press enter and leave it empty. Enter again to leave it empty, and the key is created. SSH key gene created for us two files. One file is for the private key. I will open it, but remember, it should never leave your computer. And the second file, it is bRepo1.pub. It is a public key, and later we will copy it to Bitbucket. I'll close the text editor, and I will create the keys for the Bitbucket 2. Again, SSH key gen, the type is ECDSA, number of bits 521, and the comment will be Bitbucket repo 2. Enter. The file name will be bRepo 2. Enter. Leave it empty. Enter. Enter again. The second pair of keys is created. Now I will create the keys for the GitHub. Just change the comment GitHub. The file name will be gRepo1. Enter. No passphrase. Leave it empty. Enter. Enter. And the third pair of keys is created. Remember again, the private key should never leave your computer. Now it is time to add the public keys to the repositories. Let's add the key to GitHub. I go to GitHub. I go to my account settings. Find the SSH and GPG keys. New SSH key. Title. Tutorial. Key 1. We open the public key. Select everything. Copy. And paste. Add SSH key. We can close the text editor and we can delete the public key because we no longer need it. Now let's try to clone from GitHub. I open my file explorer and I will create a new folder, repositories. I open the terminal and go to that folder. And now I will try to clone from GitHub, writing the command git clone, open the browser, go to our repository, open the repository, and here we select the SSH tab and copy the address. Copied, open the terminal again, paste it, and press enter. It asks us if we want to trust the key, write yes, enter, and here is the problem, permission denied, because our machine cannot find the private key. We have to tell Git where is the private key. I'm going to create a config file and specify the path to the private key. For this, I need Dolphin again. Open Dolphin, open home directory in a new tab, go to it, and here we need to create a folder .ssh. It is the same for Windows and also for Linux. Enter, go to that folder and create the config file. No extension, just the name config. Open the config file and start writing things. First, we need the host, it is GitHub, enter, identity file, space, home path, the folder SSH, the folder keys, and now very important, we have to copy the key name. Rename, copy, paste, save, and the config file is ready. Now we have to create the keys folder and move the private key from our tutorial folder to the keys folder in the SSH directory. It is ready. Let's try to clone again. Open the repositories folder, open the terminal, and write the command git clone, copy the address again, paste, enter. Yes, we want to continue. And it failed because I forgot to add the domain name in the host. So I will copy the domain, open the config file, and paste here the domain name. Open the Dolphin, open terminal, and try to clone again. Up arrow, the command is ready, enter, cloning, success, it works. So we cloned from GitHub using SSH keys, congratulations. Let's try to clone from Bitbucket. For this, I want to add the public key to Bitbucket account. So I go to the keys folder in our tutorial directory, open the public key, we will need it later, close the config file, open Bitbucket, go to our account settings, it is unresolved, very important, personal settings, SSH keys, add key, label tutorial 1, copy the public key, open the browser, paste it, add key. So our public key is added to Bitbucket. Go to repositories, open bitrepo, close the text editor, and delete the public key because we no longer need it. Go to repositories folder, open terminal, and let's write the clone command. Go to Bitbucket, we have a button clone, select SSH, copy, open terminal, paste, enter, yes, we want to continue, and it failed, because we didn't specify the path to the private key. Let's do it now. We no longer need this window, but we need to go to the config file, create a new host, it will be bitbucket.org. I will copy it from the git clone command, paste it here, and specify the path to the private key. The config file is ready. Now I want to move the private key from our tutorials directory to the SSH directory. The key is here, it is ready. Go to repositories folder and try to clone again. I click the up arrow, enter. Congratulations, it worked. We managed to clone the Bitbucket repository. Let's add the public key to the second Bitbucket repository. I go to the another browser. It is Yuri Fio account. I go to his personal settings, SSH keys, add key, tutorial 2. I open the public key, copy everything, close it, paste the public key, and add the key. Congratulations, the public key is added to the second repository. Let's try to clone from this repository. We already know it won't work, but I want to show you it. We no longer need the public key, delete it. Go to repositories folder, open the terminal, pass the clone command, it is yurifio account, press enter, and it failed. Forbidden, because Git doesn't know where is the private key. I think you already know we have to add the path of the private key to config file. So first what I do, I move the private key to the keys location, I open the config file, and I will copy the identity file line and specify the path to the private key. Enter. Let's try to clone again. Up arrow, enter. It failed. Why? Because Git checks the first private key. It doesn't work. It fails and Git doesn't want to check for the second key. We'll create the second host for this. Delete the private key from the first host and delete the first private key from the second host. So we have a host with bitrepo 1 key and another host with bitrepo 2 key. Save. Let's try to clone again and it will fail. As I told you, it failed because Git looks in the first host for the private key. It doesn't work, so Git doesn't even try to check the second private key. Let's create a good configuration. We need to make a small modification and add the host name. It will be the domain name. Let's copy it. Select, copy, paste, copy this line, and paste again. And what we need to do is to modify one of the hosts. We can write here anything we want, literally. Anything you want. Save, and let's try to clone from the yurifio. We delete the bitbucket.org. Copy the host, paste it in terminal, enter, and it worked. We have the bitrepo 1, bitrepo 2, and gripo 1. Let's check again. I will delete all the repositories, and I will try to clone again. Go to GitHub, copy the address. We no longer need this file, I will close it. Open the repositories folder, open the terminal, git, clone, insert, enter. It worked. Let's clone the bitbucket from unresolved. Clone, copy the command, close, open the terminal, pass the command, enter. It worked. And let's clone the last bitbucket repository. Open yurifio account, clone, copy the command, past it, and now replace the bitbucket org with bitbucket anything you want. The command is ready. Open the Dolphin, open terminal, enter. It worked. As final step, I want to show you that we can push to those repositories. Let's push to gRepo1. I open that folder, I open the readme file. I will add a line. My first commit. Save, close. Let's open gRepo1, readme file, some commit, save, close. Let's go to gRepo2. Let's create a new file. My file. Let's add some text. Save. Close. I will create three tabs in my terminal. The first one will be GitHub, the second one B1, and the third one B2. Let's go to GitHub folder, gRepo1, check the status, adding everything to the stage, check the status again, let's commit it, my first commit, enter, check the status, we are ready to push, git push, and it worked. Let's do the same, gRepo1. Git status, git add, git status again, git commit, the message, first commit, git status again, ready to push, then git push. It worked. Let's go to gRepo2, git status, git add everything, git status again, git commit, the message will be added. New file, git status, and ready to push, git push. We pushed to three repositories. Let's check if they have our changes. The second repository has the new file we created. The first Bitbucket repository has the README edited. And the GitHub repository also has the README file edited. It is all I wanted to show you. Please remember, the SSH connection is secure until you are the only one who has the private key. Rotate the keys regularly and store them securely. Make them complex, use a big number of bits. Thank you for watching.